or he has this putt for the lead out on the course, so let's rejoin Alex Hay and Peter Alice.
Yes, indeed, Seve here on the 8th, a good-looking second shot, but a bit strong. Down the green. Cross that little slope. Will it go enough? Not quite, no, just tails away. Although the greens aren't quite as fast as we've seen them in previous years, or as they've been in previous years, there's still one or two spots where the surfaces are a bit treacherous, changes of pace, uphill, downhill.
He's becoming quite a force in his own right on the European Tour, already won the Dutch Open. Now Seve, who is a joint leader with Langer and Montgomery at 8-under, this to stay that way at the 8. Nicely into the middle. His second shot just climbed the ridge. It's the ridge that you want to land on and spin back to the flag. Seve's ball just flew over the top. But great to see him in such quite a ramp there. You mustn't be short.
Seve's tee shot at the 9th. Pulled it. Has he pulled it? No. He hasn't pulled it. In fact, it's gone a little bit t'other way, but stays just on the edge of the fairway. And unless there's any...
That's the view as you look up the 9th hole. It's 441. Many of you will remember it as the 18th, as Peter was saying earlier. And no fairway bunkers, but a very testing hole. And today it goes straight back into the breeze. So it usually demands 2 or 3 iron second shot. Elevated green, pin up the right-hand side. The player can only see the top two-thirds of it. And there's a lovely card, isn't it, for Seve? 2 birdies and the rest pars. And he really, over the last few months, has established himself back almost as the force that he was. Lovely tempo. If you watch from this position how quickly he breaks into his hand action in the backswing, just at the point where he starts the backswing, you'll see a lot of hand movement. But in the old days, it used to drop, it used to lower. Now it happens and doesn't pull him down. Just watch, focus on his hands. You see how sharply he went into that. He's aiming left and hoping for it to drift to the right, but not quite as far as that. It's gone into the sand. We just see it popping out at the bottom of the bunker. Third shot will be into the breeze. What there is of it. And that hand action sometimes gets a little busy. Although it doesn't pull him down, it's if you start off with a busy hand action, you've got to do something about it around the ball. And there is the ball sitting quite tidily. Now, Jimenez, who hit a very good tee shot, past the maestro. Jimenez at 5-under. Started at 7-under. He's had a few dropped shots, a 3rd and 4th, and the 6th. Now you see a contrast of swings here, slithering legs, movement, lots of movement. He held it up. It seems more solid than Seve's. Yes, it is. He's starting to gain his confidence. That is a classic shot. That is beautifully struck. And we move up to the bunker where Seve, the master at work, in a sort of lime green color today. Soft colors he's wearing. Now you see just the open stance and the blade just lightly gripped and laid back. It's a sort of nice gravelly feel about the sand, sort of crushed marble. Flange set down, face open, and pop. They never cease to amaze you. It's just the master at work. You give them good conditions and they'll tear the place apart. That sand is so perfect, it's a sort of ground down crystal, not crystal, but marble, a ground down marble, and that's where you can get control, the open face sand iron. You can just lightly talk to the ball and create all sorts of spins, and no one has a better pair of hands than this man. Let's have a look at it again. There it is, just a splash, First you see it, then you don't. And lands as light as a feather onto that green. Almost the ultimate shot. Four for Seve.
Yes, and he's hit a good tee shot. And there you can see how the ground slopes left to right ahead of him. Narrowish entrance to this green, which is perched up on top of the hill, with the most spectacular view across to Duquesa and Gibraltar away to the right, and the Mediterranean stretching out in front of you. And Seve's going to rip one up there. Looks like a driver, going to low skimmer. I fancy he might aim at that left-hand bunker and cut it in low. Stayed there, didn't get any cut. It's all right though. Now he's got a tricky one across the corner of the bunker, but he's safe enough. It is a par five, and there you are. That's the view. Well, it's probably a bit of artist's license. I think our friendly cameraman's about, he's less than 9,000 feet up in the air, but he's quite high looking across the course, which with the lovely villas and houses dotted around early is very spectacular. Lovely part for today. Now Seve's third. This is tricky, but he's got a fair bit of uphill green to pitch onto between him and the flag. Needs to go right a bit. Oh, it stopped very quickly. And he might have hoped for a little bit more run out of that one down to the hole. That's still pretty good. Putt of 6 or 7 feet.
Everyone knows exactly what is going on around. So Jimenez puts a birdie down on his scorecard. We've seen quite a few scorecards showing up today. And if you're confused by the length of the course, those are meters instead of yards that we're used to. Now, can Seve get a birdie? Well, he had that to take the outright lead. It is remarkable, isn't it? Jimenez putt would have been considered a bit of a nightmare to some. And Seve, the easier of the two, and he doesn't get it. But it's a nice, tidy card. He hasn't dropped a single shot, and that is quite unusual. Over they go. Let's have a look at Jimenez again. Big break from the right. He has to come up out of that hollow. Then they boldly hit it takes the break right to left, and then starts racing down. If he misses the hole, he's going 6 or 7 feet past. But he didn't. Watch the expression. Well, he looked delighted. Seve didn't look too interested as he got caught up in the picture there. And over they go to the short 12th. And this is a tricky hole, Peter.
Yes, this is one of the most
Bermuda cotton wool, it feels like.
Jimenez has played his tee shot to 8-9 feet or so. Now Seve, one of the joint leaders. Say that may be over there down towards the 13th tee. That was a big yahoo. That's down in Dead Man's Gulch, that one, with the flag on this side of the green. Well, we don't know where that's gone. It's there's caddies in with the rake. Seve marches down the hill looking at a very tricky pitch back through the trees. Well, he's down well below the level of the green, and that looks a straightish face club. We haven't had a view of what's facing him, but I fancy it's fairly, if memory serves me, I don't think there's anything in the way other than a bank. There's no bunker, so he might just give this a bump into the still hillside and hope for the best. There's certainly not much room to pitch it on top and try and hold it, but he may be already settling for a a four, but well, I don't know, suddenly that club doesn't, I don't know what he's going to do here. Looks, the practice swing looks as if he might be trying to flip it up. Doesn't look as if he's going to knock it into the hillside. But I fancy he is trying to hit the top of the bank. Nope, fooled us all. Flipped it up in the air. I tell you what, this fella does play some shots. He, there really was, well, an area the size of a child's handkerchief to land that one on. Jimenez gets his three. He stays at 600, just two behind. And Seve, after that miraculous floating, chopping pitch from out of the cork trees, there's a little tester for his par. Have you noticed how the briskness has come back into Seve's stride? Everything, he's, the eyes are bright and the coat is shiny. The nose is chilly and he's ready for anything. Straight and firm. What a three. Yeah, this is what cheeses you off when you play somebody like that. You play a wonderful shot to within 10 or 12 feet of the hole, a bit less. You take three. And the man you're playing with misses the lead by 25 yards. But quite a small target.
Jimenez just taking on the 13th. You see the pin only a few feet up the green, 402-yarder. As Peter was describing it earlier, you come in over trees. There seems to be no way to escape coming in. You see the trees on the left here hanging well out, but allow for the wind. And the tartan pattern now, you get an idea of the slope into the swell. There's his partner's ball side by side, so he'll have Seve sort of breathing down his neck, watching everything. And there's the score. He started a bit shakily, dropped three shots in the opening six holes, so he was two over par going out, thanks to a birdie on the eighth. And although he's only, he's one under coming back, he has missed a succession of putts, apart from the big one that he had at 12, at 11. Quite a long club this. It looks very much like a six iron, just 150, 150 yards to go, controlling the wind. It looks a tidy shot, beautifully poised. There it is a beautiful shot. It never left the flag from the minute he struck it. He does play some great golf and he's getting better. It's no fluke, this man, Dutch Open champion, second in two other tournaments and six top 10 finishes this year. So this is his best ever season. And what a time to do it. So what did Seve learn from that? You hit it straight at the flag, it doesn't move. Same distance, 150 yards, maybe an inch or two less. Probably the same numbered club. I talked earlier about the business of his wrist action being very sharp. It's much smoother on the driver. It gets quite active on the irons. Watch it. And that's a tidy shot as well. He'd like it to drift a wee bit. Maybe going too much right. Yes, a lot right, 15 feet. Some spectacular golf, Peter, isn't it? The scintillating stuff they play.
Yes, they're striking the ball quite beautifully because the greens are so receptive. If the ball lands on the green, it stops nicely. The world is a lovely place when you're striking the ball out the middle of the bat.
Not for today, one drop shot, the rest par.
That's the 13th. Seve first to putt. We're often asked if any of the caddies play, and the answer is yes, and as the caddies get more beautiful and younger as the years go by, they get to play better. There's been an inaugural match. The Golfing Press Association took on the caddies, the European Tour caddies, at Kingswood, that lovely club near Walt. There's young Billy, he played. 12 aside, and they stuffed the press 6-0. Much to their embarrassment. 6-0. The old caddies sloshed the old scribes. got well and truly toshed. That'll teach him. That'll teach him. Now Seve for a three. To take the lead. He's prowling around a bit. You always get the feeling with Seve when he's sort of in full flow that he can perform miracles like a sort of Uri Geller. You can't really believe it, but he does the most extraordinary things at times. Good strike. No, went away. He just... Well, it went that way. Accident leads by one.
And Seve, who has also selected the one iron, 14th. He won't know that he's leader yet, but he soon will. The sun in the eyes. And that is very short by comparison. That just shows you that Jimenez is no slouch. That one iron has gone a long way down the fairway. So get his maximum backspin.
Seve now at the 14th. Elevated green. 14th hole. 370 yards. So long, long iron off the tee for position. A beauty. Just real target golf now with the greens as receptive as they are.
There's off the lead.
Seve to step into a two-stroke lead. This is a niggly putt too. Cross the green, right to left, fast. Just down the right side, right in. It's funny how the game fluctuates, doesn't it? Very, very quickly. Just seemingly minutes ago, there were three of them tied at 8 under. And now there are three at 7 under, and Seve, 2 strokes ahead of them at 9 under. This is one of those silly putts that can be missed too, if you're just a little bit edgy with it. So he's just left of centre, firm. If he goes right of centre and sort of babies it, it can dribble away. Yeah, well done. Notice how carefully they putt those. 15th, the last of the short holes. Again, a big iron. Flag today, back right. There's room up the left-hand side. When I say room, there's a couple of bunkers and the bank up the left-hand side. And with the pin back right today, you really don't want to go drifting away down the hill on the right-hand side. Well, that chip in of Montgomery's puts him 1 stroke behind Seve at 8 under. And Montgomery's hold 2 chips, not easy chips, as Alex was saying, difficult ones, and then another one at the 10th, which he put virtually stone dead. Oy vey, whatever that means. Young Bill, seen it all, seen it, done it, bored. Yes, finds the green, long way from the hole. See the big left to right borrow, and very fast. Seve, of course, will have a putt across the green. Not easy either.
Ian Woosnam waiting at the 17th. Is he going to have a go or is he going to lay up? Yesterday evening I suggested that Jimenez would be laying up, and we all know what he did. But this looks rather like the long iron. I can only think Ian's going to have a crack at it. The pin tucked right on the corner, the right-hand side, and it will take a good deal. Mind he's got the right sort of shape. If you can come in on the right. First day we saw Ballesteros play in on the right-hand side, drifted in on the curve. It's quite a strange design. The front of this green looks very like some of Augusta's holes.
Seve at the 15th, long putt for a two. Good pace.
To the 16th, Seve's second shot carried the band of rough, but just screwed back off the green against the fringe. And it'll be interesting, the line is right to left for him, but interesting just how thick the rough is behind the ball, that sort of stubbly grass. Quite fascinating, the subject of grass this week. It's sort of Bermuda in the rough. The greens are very fine, soft sand, so even when you see spike marks, they don't seem to deflect the ball. There's a softness in the grass. And Seve looks as though he's got no real problem here. Big break right to left, no problem hitting it, I mean. Judging the distance, that's not easy. Leads by two. And he hasn't given that enough. Neither high enough nor long enough. Wonderful to see him back this year. Started our figures on this course. 10 under was the winning score last year. It was his, and that was some 7 or 8 shots better than ever been done before. And he doesn't want to be losing to par in this third round. Now Bernhard coming down the hill, a great tee shot. Starts moving to the right. So what I mean about not wanting to putt down the hill.
Please.
There's just one win in Europe this year, the Murphy's Irish Open.
Yeah.
The second place and a few thirds.
Jimenez is at the 16th. After that lovely iron, but you see the putting has suddenly begun to look a little tentative. Perhaps on the wrong side of the greens.
Firm up the hill for Langer for a three. Pushed it, another shot drop for Bernard. They're starting to run away from Seve. Running backwards, 6 under now and 3 behind Ballesteros. Seve won't be able to believe his luck when he looks up at the strategically placed leaderboards.
And here he is for a par at the 16th. Nicely done. Just 2 holes left, a 5 and a 4 par. He has not dropped 1 stroke to par today. Seve just had, he's had the 3 birdies. And this 17th hole, well, it's a long one, 511 yards, 467 metres. And bushes and trees on the right. Fairway tilts a bit right to left. So the big hitters try and keep it as far to the right as they can and get a shoot off the bank. It's a different looking hole, just the one bunker there. Now this has been remodeled since these pictures were taken, and the bunker at the back is now one bunker. But the flag pretty well in the position it is there, and Seve going for a big drive down the right, wind helping. If he gets a good drive away, then he's got a very good chance of getting on for two and making a birdie. There it is, just on the edge of the rough, and didn't get a big shoot. Not bad. It's okay. Now, the pin is over the right. that green rubbish bin tied on the end there. The green's, the flag is to the right of that. Oh, what a shot. Just a little too, oh, steady on. And it's coming back a bit, it's coming back. No, it stopped on the downslope. That could be an awkward little shot for Seve. Plenty of power there. But lying beautifully, you can see. And it's not so much on the downslope as I thought.
Let's press, let shots go away. He's too close to this man to do that.
Now Ballesteros has gone through the green with his second shot. Coming down to get a look at a lie of the land. It must swing quite a lot left to right. It's caddy here in the foreground. So I would think if you took a line over the top of Billy's head, Seve's caddy, and where Seve is now, that's the sort of line where he's got to land it and then let the ball ease down to the hole. It's a par five, so it's not... It won't be too bad if he takes three from here, but he doesn't want to do that with his magical short game. He should be able to do it. He's done it often enough in the past. Just on the downslope, playing it with a lofted club, weight on the left side, 70% probably of his weight on his left leg as he settles into the shot. Watch the pace of the club through the ball. Firmly down, up onto the top, too hard. Clumsy, it's off the green. Oh, a little something under the ball there, look at that, you struck off.
Shot.
Seve ahead at the green, fourth shot. Staying up on the high ground. So a well struck second that just went through the green, not able to get down in a chip and a putt for once. Oh, I say, isn't that lovely? That's the little weir that runs from this new pond down to the little stream alongside the left-hand side as the players come up the 17th. Much better hole now than it used to be. It just used to be a dreadful old slog up the fairway. Nobody really cared for. Now at least it's got a bit of animation and a bit of interest to it. Seve's little putt. In. Par five. Might have been better, but it's okay. Stays two ahead at the moment. Let's have a look at Seve. Ah, there he is. I thought he hadn't slipped away. Well, he's taking a long time just selecting a tree, a line. Yeah, just a good, sensible drive. Don't spoil it on this last hole. One over the left side. Oh, he's done it perfectly. Didn't get much of a run. We have seen drives been slightly raised, as you can see up at the end there. Almost 30 yards long, this green, from front to back. Well, we've got 150 odd yards, that sort of thing. That looked to be a bit heavy. If anything, it's gone left, surely. Yes. is over the top of that. That was not a good shot from a man of his calibre. But a man of his calibre can certainly get up and down in two from the sand, although he took three from the edge of the last hole. A difficult chip, the old flashing eyes. Well, now Seve's been up and down and round and about, and we've seen him play a couple of wonderful bunker shots and little chip shots. It's such a surprise when he takes more than two to get down from round and about the green. Ball looks to be lying nicely. There it is. Looks like Jodrell Bank or one of those sort of filing dales. Sitting nicely. Just watch the length of swing, and the club accelerates through, and it should go fairly high. Now we saw Olathaba play one out of here. It came up short. He played it a little too softly. You can be bold and land it right by the pin. If you get some elevation on it, it'll stop within a foot or two. Your legs go funny, I tell you. It really does. It's absolutely a delight to watch. The style, the swing, the walk, the gait, the arrogance. It's glorious. Absolutely glorious. The only time he ever seemed to go wrong was when he tried to play golf by numbers. And if there's one man in the world that shouldn't play golf by numbers, it's this guy. Touch and feel. Look at the knees nicely bent. Club face open. Look at the length of the backswing. And quite firm. You see how hard he hit the ball? The club sliding underneath. Up she goes. And there it is. Most people don't get out of bunkers because they don't hit the ball hard enough. They don't get into the sand and slice it underneath. There it is. Whoosh. Up she comes. And the result, certain four, and Seve will go in after 3 days of play at 9 under. So that's averaging 68.
One over for the day, 6 under and 3 behind Seve, who would just complete. Lovely four. Wonderful bunker shot. An exhibition, not a single shot drop. The par is 71, he's 3 under. And you can see how he balanced it. Two lovely birdies going out, another one coming home. Perfect round of golf, just the right time to do it. He's 9 under and he leads at this moment by the